said, tell him to come to me. And then he went to Elisha. The Bible says he drove up there with his chariot and his servants, and he stood at Elisha's house by the door. Elisha sent a servant to him, and Elisha said, go and tell Naaman that he must go and wash 7 times in the Jordan River, and he's going to be clean. But Naaman was so angry, he's wrong, the Bible says, he was upset, because he came with a mindset, he came saying that, well, the man of God would have come out, call on his God, and pass his hand upon me, or lay his hand upon this spot, and this spot would disappear. Naaman came prepared for a miracle. Naaman came prepared for a breakthrough. He came prepared to receive something from the man of God. But what he prepared wasn't enough. He came prepared outwardly. He came prepared with his chariots. He came prepared with his servants. He came prepared with maybe gold and silver. He came prepared with everything outside. But ladies and gentlemen, he didn't prepare the right way. When he came, I know without a shadow of a doubt, Naaman, he went and showered before he went to Israel. I know he went and maybe he take a good bath and he present himself so nice. Maybe he put on the best garment that he could find, that he will look so good before the Israel king. But the ladies and gentlemen, he said, at least I thought you would have come out and see me. I can imagine you wear your best clothes, you have your best chariots, you have all the goodies out there, I have servants and everybody, look how much I prepare to come and see this man, and this man refused to see me. This man is telling me to go and dip in Jordan River 7 times. Ladies and gentlemen, what Elisha was saying to him, go and wash. Go and wash. He did not like that. He didn't like that because he wanted to just get a touch, get healed, and go back to his business. But I come to tell you, God is not in that business. God is not in that business to fix you up so you can go back into the world and serve another God. He's not in that business. So Naaman prepared, and Naaman did prepare himself outwardly. He prepared himself outwardly, washed good, but something as he see on the inside that nobody could have seen. The servants can't see what is on the inside. The king can't see what is on the inside, but the servant of God, God sees on the inside. The Bible says he was wroth, he was angry. On the inside of Naaman, there was anger. There was bitterness. There was rage. There were so many things on the inside of Naaman that nobody could see. And that is why he said, go and wash. He said, look, Jordan River, choose another river. There's Abna and Pharpar. These rivers are much cleaner than Jordan. I can go up there and I can dip. I can wash there. Ladies and gentlemen, it is not within your power to tell God how you are going to get your miracle. It's not within your power to dictate and tell God, I don't want this and I don't want that, and you don't tell me what to do. I need a healing. Sorry, you're going to leave just like Naaman and go back with your leprosy. Just so you come with your arrogant self, you're going to leave the house of God with all your problems, with all your sickness, with all your disease, and everything that you came with. He was angry. There are lots of people come to the house of God, and when they get the truth, they're vexed, they're angry. I am come for that. I come for healing. I come for financial breakthrough. I come for miracle. I come for the hospital. until you get rid of it, until you really wash up. He said, I am going to go to rivers, and I can dip there. Some of us say, well, I don't need to obey God's word. I can do something else to get my miracle. I don't need to hear the truth. I don't need somebody to tell me to come out a sinner, and somebody to tell me that what I'm doing is wrong. I will sow a seed and I can get a breakthrough. No, sir. It can't happen. You gotta do it God's way, or you're gonna remain the same. He wants to choose his river. He wants to choose his river. He wants to choose his river. But inside of Naaman, there was pride. Oh, you want to tell the captain of the Syrian army to dip in Jordan River? The pride of many of us not receiving from God, because we for the pride, we stuck up and we don't want to do what God wants us to do. He was vexed, he was angry, and he went to it. I guess Elisha's servant, Gehazi, said to Elisha, demand God. Demand and go in and dip, demand God, demand vexed, demand angry. Elisha said to him, look at me good, I ain't got leprosy. You ain't got leprosy, he got it. And if he want to live with it, so be it. So when you come with your problem and you get vexed with the pastor, upset with the word, and you want to live with your problem, so be it. I ain't got a problem. I go to sleep. I am not sick. I am healthy. But if you were a little thing to break your pride and your arrogance, you don't want to do it, so be it. He walked away. Gentlemen, we can choose so many other things to do and tell ourselves we're going to get our breakthrough. We got the money and you say, well, I can pay for it. No. Nothing can wash away your sin but the blood of Jesus. You got to dip into the blood of Jesus. You got to come in contact with Jesus. You got to come in contact with the blood. You can't push the blood aside. Push Jesus aside. That's how we pay for it. It can't work. God made a way, and Jesus is the way. And if he said Jesus got it, you got to come to Jesus. You can't walk away angry. If Jesus said it, it shall be done. In Hebrews 10 and verse 4 it says, for it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away the sins. You can kill fall cock, you can kill goat, you can kill sheep, you can kill cow, it can't wash away your sin. Said it's not possible. Only the blood of Jesus. You gotta come in contact with the blood. But Jesus got your miracle. Jesus got your breakthrough. Jesus got your deliverance. Jesus got your healing. You gotta come to Jesus if you want your deliverance. Want to choose another river, but there is only one Jordan. There is only one Jesus. There is not another Jesus. One, the true and the living one, who rose from the dead. He said, go and wash. I guess that was upsetting to him. Wash. I wash with the best water before I come to see you. In Syria, the best spring I use to wash myself thoroughly. And you're still telling me to wash. We can be so self-righteous. We can still see our no fault in us. We can see we are so pure and holy and righteous. But on the inside, Jesus says, you're like white sepulchre, clean and white outside, but inside is dead man bones. It's rotten on the inside. It's deep on the inside. It's filthy on the inside. Unless you clean up the inside, the outside can't be healed. I'm talking to somebody today. What is on the inside is affecting the outside. But if Jesus was on the inside, he would have worked on the outside. You gotta come right with God. Recently, and I guess some of you it happened too, that sometimes you see some spots coming out of your skin. Are you getting some boils coming out on your skin? And you buy some medication, you put on top of it, and it go away for a while, and then it come back up. But when you go and you see the doctor will tell you, there is some liver spot. You gotta drink something because you gotta deal with it from the inside. Then on the outside is gonna go. But some of us want to fix the outside, and temporarily, for a day it look fixed. But tomorrow it gone back to normal. But I'm telling you, get on the inside and prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare the way for the physician. Prepare the way for the way maker. Prepare the way for the deliverer. Prepare the way for the Prince of Peace. So let Jesus come on the inside, and peace is on the inside. They're gonna spit out on the outside. And you're gonna find peace in your home, peace in your job, peace of yourself. And Jesus is on the inside. Said, go and wash. Vex, bitter, resentment. I can imagine the things he said about Elisha. I can imagine the things he said about him. But Elijah said he can go his way. He's a leprosy. He a leper. He needs thy God. I don't care how big he is. I don't care what position he holds in the Syrian army. He need my God. Go and wash. You see, Elijah knows exactly the root of the problem of Naaman. He knows exactly where the problem lies, and was telling them the problem is on the inside, not on the outside. But when he went home, I could imagine he went back, and the little girl saw him and said, Father, Master, what happened? The prophet that you tell me about. The man didn't come to look at me. The man tell me to go dip in Jordan River. So I don't know who you recommend. I thought the prophet should be a loving man, should be a nice man, should be a kind man. But he's not, he's a straight up man. Some of us want friends as pastors. Some of our buddies as pastors, we don't want nobody strip and straight up and tell you where you sit or where you err or what you're doing wrong. You don't want that. You want somebody nice who will be impressed with you. Sorry, if you're a living word, you're going to get the real stuff. You're going to get the real thing. Oh my God. He said, the little child said to him, he said, if you tell him to do something big, would you do it? He said, but that's a little thing. But let me tell you this. We don't like our flesh get touched. The Bible says, obedience is better than sacrifice. Yes. So we prefer to make sacrifice, but not to walk in obedience. So if he says to do something big, I will do that. I will do something big, but how dare you tell me that I am a sinner? How dare you tell me that I got unforgiveness inside of me? How dare you tell me that I got bitterness inside of me? How dare you tell me that? You don't want to hear that. You want to hear you're a nice person. But if you want your deliverance, you got to get down on the inside. You got to get down on the inside. The man of God said to him, dip 7 times. Completion. Not no halfway thing. Some of us sit halfway in our Christian walk. You better get fully committed to God. And stop walking halfway. And 2 steps forward, 1 step backward. Keep pressing on with your God. No halfway thing. He said 7 times. After the child spoke with him, he came to himself. After all, what this man is saying gotta be true. Sometimes when you hear it from the pastor mouth, you get upset. Somebody has got to tell you. Somebody, maybe your husband or your wife, or your children, or your friend, or somebody has got to say, they're going to tell you if you don't want to hear what the man of God have to say. And the little child said, "Mom, we should go and wash." I guess pick himself up back now, after he sit and settle down and head into Jordan, with his servants and in his chariots, head into Jordan, humbling himself, seeing the captain of the Syrian army. People, they're watching at him. You used to be in all the nice water. Let me see now what you're going to do. Gotta decide, brother. I rode up to Jordan, and I could imagine, when I read the Bible, I see pictures, right? And I could imagine this man, when I read the scripture, I begin to laugh. I could imagine being able to jump out of his beautiful chariot with his beautiful garment, nice clean silk looking garment, and there's a dirty stinking river. And them boys may be telling him, "Why are you going into that water? Take it come out worse. Take it come out worse." But you have to obey the voice of the servant of God. And if you imagine him step into the water, water smells stink, water stagnant, and he went into the water, and the servants looking at him, "Look at our master, look at the captain of the Syrian army in Jordan River." And he went down one time, came up back, 2 times, came up back, look at his skin, it's still there. Maybe those guys are up there counting for him. You only got 2 more. You got 5 more to go. 5 up, 6 up. Look at the skin still there. But the prophet says 7 times. The man says, "Well, if I go 6, at least I'm supposed to see something looking like if it's happening." But when he went down the 7th time, and when he came up back, you walk away from God, you will remain that same. jealous, your jealousy get bigger. And you look over the neighbor, and you see neighbor get something, I got to get one of your blessings. So when you see your brother get blessings, say, Lord, thank you that mine is coming next. Don't get bitter, don't get angry, don't get jealous. Get it out of your system. Get it out. Hosea 10, chapter 12, he said, break up your funeral drama, for it's time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. The spirit is contaminated. The spirit is grieved. The spirit is suffering because you fail to uproot those things that are in the heart. Isaiah 1 and 19 says, if you be willing and obedient, he shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Are you willing to come to God and ask God to reveal through you? Are you willing to repent of your sin? Are you willing to walk away from that ungodly relationship? Are you willing to stop living home and get married? Are you willing to stop lying and speak the truth? Are you willing to walk? He said, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. The choice is yours. If you are willing and obedient, God is going to give it good to you. God is going to flourish you. But there is something's got to come out. You know what I'm talking about. God knows what I'm talking about. Your friend might not know the person sitting next to you, don't know. They might smell nice and sweet, looking good and flourishing, but inside, God is saying it's rotten, it's ugly. I want to fix what is on the outside, but first I got to fix on the inside. Neighbor rose up and he was clean, and when he looked at himself, see himself clean. Jump back into his chariot. Rush back to Elisha. Call out Elisha. And he said, there is no God in all the earth except the God of Israel. You see, Elisha lay hands on him, and he would have get the healing and gone back. But when Elisha sent him to go and dip, and when he really got clean, his eyes were open. And he saw the real God. And he came back and he said to Elisha, he said, let me bless you. Let me give you something. I was angry with you. I was upset with you. But you tell me the truth. And because I obey the truth, now I am clean. I know a lot of people get upset with me. They talk bad about me. Yes, but I'm here to guide you to your blessings. I'm here to guide you to your breakthrough. I'm here to tell you the truth so you can be free. I'm here to tell you the truth so that you can get your deliverance. You might be upset. He came back and he said to Elisha, he said, let me bless you. He said, no. He said, no, I will not take anything from you. He said, well, if you're not going to take anything from me, give me something. He said, I'm asking for 2 mules weight of earth. Give me 2 mules weight of earth that I'm going to take it back to Syria. That I will, from today, I will not bow to any false god but to the God of Israel. I'm saying to you, when you come in contact with God and God heals you, you need not to turn back and go serving any false god. You need the sort of God that heals you, the God that delivers you, the God that sets you free. Some of us come, taste and see that the Lord is good. We eat, we get bread, we get healing, we get deliverance, and we walk away. I spoke with somebody and they asked about deliverance. I said, deliverance is easy. I said, 5 minutes you can get deliverance, that's easy. I said, but what other people don't warn you about if you don't keep your deliverance? The scripture says, when you cast out the demon, it goes and it roams. And if it finds nowhere to rest, it comes back. And if that place that is swept and garnished, not occupied, he will not enter. He go in and bring 7 demons stronger than himself. He said, come on, let us go back now. So your first stage will be 7 times worse than your last stage. What God said, ladies and gentlemen, is that you will get 7 times worse if you don't walk. I said to the person, if you are not ready for deliverance, don't get into it. Stay with the 1 demon what you have now, rather than the 7 coming upon you. So decide what you want. I'm telling you the truth. I can tell you, yes, 7 carry true deliverance, and you come back into the 1, then come back to me 7 times worse, so stress me out. No, me ain't that. Do what is right. Yes. He told